Okay, you can start.
Okay. My name is Emmanuel Taadi, a senior health services administrator at Kwahu Government Hospital in the Eastern Region. Our facility happened to be one of those selected to benefit from this SBM-R process. So we're part of the initial training in the module one, and six members from our hospital benefited, mainly in quality assurance teams and then midwives who deliver the training in the reproductive health unit. After the training, we brief our management and we form an SBM implementation task force in the hospital. An initial baseline survey was done, and that gave us an idea as to the level we're meeting with the standards and what the gaps and then the problems were. And they were many, I must say, because we hadn't gone through this process, and then there were a lot of lapses. But after the baseline survey, we used the gaps and the problems to form an action plan, which we work on. And I must say that after some time, after about 3 months of implementation, we did a review by doing a second internal monetary assessment. Obviously, that one was an improvement over the initial one, because in the interim, we have done a lot of gaps filling. For example, in the labor ward, we had to provide them with a lot of logistics which were not there before. We had to give them trolleys to contain equipment, emergency equipment which are needed at the point of delivery. Mm. We had to give them communication equipment, and even the skills. We had to liaise with Jhpiego to train most of the other midwives who didn't benefit from the initial process. And that alone has even enhanced their skill and gave them confidence to do processes which hitherto they were not comfortable with. And as I said, the second internal monitoring process showed it, because many of the gaps were filled. There are still a lot of gaps to go through, and I'm sure that as the process is ongoing, as we do more training, as we provide more of the logistics needs that are identified in the assessment gaps, and then as we lay with Jhpiego and then the other collaborators to provide this, to provide all the other things that are needed, I think we'll be making very big way. I must say that the SBM-R process has been a lot of benefit to our hospital in particular, because now there's a lot of awareness about the program in the hospital. Midwives are conscious to do the little things that they thought they were not important and that they ignored, or which had fatal consequences. And then the hospital is also conscious about its duties to the reproductive health aspect of our care. And want to thank all those who have helped, especially Jhpiego and their partners, who thought it wise to include us in the program, because initially we were not part of the program, but because of our proximity to Birim North, and also because we received most of their referral cases, we have been included, and it has been a tremendous benefit to us. So we thank everybody.